we think we can produce hydrogen at the lowest cost relative to other technologies available to the U.K. market.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is EnergyPathways CEO Ben Clube. Ben, very good to speak with you. The government's designated mesh as nationally significant. What does this status mean in practical terms for project timelines and approvals?
The designation is a critical milestone for the mesh project in that the government has recognized that the project has national significance from the U.K.'s energy system and energy transition point of view. And so it enables the project to fall under the Planning Act 2008, which is a mechanism which allows the government to essentially progress important projects through a planning process, which essentially is a sort of a fast-tracking exercise. At the end of the day, the mesh project is targeting to contribute to clean power 2030 objectives of the government. And so we're looking to be sort of up and running operationally by 2030.
So, I mean, would you describe this then as a significant milestone for the company?
Oh, absolutely. So it's an important milestone for the company and for investors in the UK's energy transition space, and its confidence that the government backs projects such as Mesh to make what we think is going to be a meaningful contribution to the UK's clean energy and net zero goals.
You've signed agreements with Costain, Zenith Energy, and Siemens. How do these partnerships advance Mesh towards that final investment decision?
Our partnerships are with some of the global leaders in clean energy technologies and development, and we're really pleased to have these companies on board and supporting the project. They obviously see the potential of the mesh project, and that's why they're participating. With respect to the key components of mesh, kind of the critical part, lead part, let's say, of what we're doing is to address the key issue that the UK faces, which is the billions of pounds of value being lost to wasted wind power, wind curtailment. And the solution to that is energy storage. And what mesh offers here is a solution that can store excess wind power at scale and over long periods of time. Our key partner in that respect is Siemens Energy, who are a leader in long duration energy storage in the system that we're developing, which is compressed air systems. And so you know that is a key partnership to moving this project forward. From other aspects of the project, we are also developing what will be a large scale hydrogen production facility as part of the total integrated project, and that's where we're bringing where we have exclusive rights to a hydrogen production technology called methane pyrolysis, and that partnership was with Hazar Group Limited and KBR Inc. And with that, we think we can produce hydrogen at the lowest cost relative to other technologies available to the UK market.
I mean, in your interim results last week, you noted that you recently raised additional funding from investors and directors. How far will this capital take the company, and what are the next funding priorities?
Yeah, I mean, it puts us on the path. We're straight into FEED activities now with this decision. So we'll be looking to develop our sort of investment portfolio and financing options as part with those funds. And we're already getting significant interest, and there's a lot of demand, we think, to backing the company through FEED and through the development cycle.
And the upcoming milestones that your investors should be looking out for?
There'll be a number of milestones as we progress through the Planning Act 2008 process. And as we move through the FEED progress on the various compartments of the project, and various further approvals from the government as we move through that project.
And I hope you'll continue to keep us updated with your progress. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thank you.
Ben Clube, the CEO of Energy Pathways.